Hi, this is Uma Mahesh from CRM Ones. In this video, I'm going to explain about the Power Platform environments. An environment is a space for managing the company's data, apps, and flows. So by using these environments, we can achieve the different roles, different security requirements for our different target audience for the apps. So how we can leverage these environments depends upon the organizations and the apps you are trying to build. So I have listed some sample scenarios here. So we may choose to build your apps in a single environment. For example, all the dev and test and QA and for production, all these apps you want to manage in a single environment. So we may go for with the single environment. So sometimes if you want to create a separate environment that groups the test, production versions of your apps. So we can create one environment for the dev applications, one environment for the test, one environment for the production, one environment for the UAT. So in that model also we can go that. So in other scenario, we can create a separate environments that corresponding the specific groups. So like a sales team, this environment, for marketing team, this environment, for based upon the specific groups, we can create a specific teams or different departments, we can create a separate environments. So each environment, it contains the relevant data and apps for each audience. So, and also the fourth sample scenario is that we can create an environment for different global branches of your company. So like if your company is operating in India and US and Canada, so like each branch, you can have a different environment. So the scope of this environment, so each environment is created under Azure AD tenant. So each environment will be created under Azure AD tenant. So basically this Azure AD tenant for each company, they will give you in one Azure tenant ID. So in that only all our Office 365 and Azure and everything will be linked to that. So each environment is created under Azure AD tenant, and its resources can be whatever the resources can be, you can be only accessed within that tenant only. So for example, you have the one Power App. Okay, you created a one environment under the one tenant ID, and if you create the one Power App or model driven app in that environment, that environment can access the resources. It may be logic apps, it may be flows, or it may be a Power BI, whatever it's created under the tenant ID, those resources only, it can be accessed within that tenant. An environment also is bounded to the geolocation, the geographic location. Okay. An environment also is linked to the geographic location. So like if you are creating an environment, you need to select that which geographic location you are creating this environment. And when you create an app within an environment, that app also is rooted to the only that data centers in that geographic location. So any items that you create in that environment, so like including connections, gateways, flows, and Power Automate and more, are also bounded to that environment location only. Every environment can have a zero or one common data service databases which provides the storage for your apps. So for each environment, you can create a 0 or 1, at least one data, common data service databases you can create it to store your app database. So the ability to create a database for your environment will be depend upon your license you have purchased for Power Apps and your permissions within that environment. So when you create an app in an environment, that app is only permitted to connect with the data sources that are also deployed on the same environment. So here, when you create an app, so that app can be connected with the whatever the data sources you have created within that environment only. So including connections, gateways and flows and common data services. So the permissions for the environment. So basically two types of the permissions we have. One is that environment admin role and other one is the other one is the environment maker role. So this environment administrative role, it will give this all the list of the actions you can add or remove a user or a group from the environment, and you can provision a common data source database for the environment, and we can view all manage all the resources created within that environment, and you can able to set the data loss protection policies if with the environment admin role. And after creating the database in that environment, you can use the system administrator role instead of the environment administrator role to manage this all the creation of entities or all creation of relationships, fields. We can do with the system administrator role also. So the environment maker role, you can able to create the resources within that environment, including the apps, connections, custom connectors, gateways and flows using a Power Automate. The environment maker role will distribute the apps they build in an environment to other users in your organization by share this app to the individual users or security group, all other users within that organization. So let me show you what is the environment and how it will be in the system. So once you log into the admin.powerflatform.microsoft.com, and you can see the environments here. When you click on here, the environments. So these environments, so by default, when you create a Office 365 or when you log into the Power Apps portal, powerapps.com, Power Apps site, and when you log into the Dynamics 365 environment, so by default, this environment with default environment will be created. So if you have a Dynamics 365 instance, then you can able to see this one environment here. So if you want to create a new environment, you can click on here, click on new, and it will show the list of the options, and we can able to create it here. And next thing, if you want to do any settings or anything for this environment, so previously that error may cause that that my authentication is expired. So after refresh, it is little showing. So when you click on here, if you want to go to this environment, so you can see this, what is the environment and what is the details. This is my environment URL. So we can see this, what is the production type and state and which region and security groups and which version of database it is there. and you can see what's the included. And if you want to see the environment settings, if you click on the settings, which is like a for CRM developers, it is not a new thing. So whatever you can see that CRM currently under setting tab, whatever you will perform that product management, business management, and users and security roles and audit logs and templates, the emails, SharePoint integration and data management and encryption and other resources. So it's the same like in Microsoft Dynamics CRM, you have under settings tab, whatever the operations you can do it here. From here going forward for a CRM environments. And also what other things we have, if you want to manage your CRM solutions. So like if you want to install a new solutions in your environment, when you click on here, it will take to the your CRM Dynamics 365 administration. So this particular environment it came from the Dynamics 365 environment. So if you want to create your own environment for only the Power Apps, then these options it may not come. Okay, and from here you can take the backups and restore and everything you can do that environments here. And if you want to open that particular environment, if you click on it, it will open. This environment which will point to my Dynamics CRM. And if you go back to the environments, and if you click on here three dots, you can see this open environment settings manage. And if you want to copy this environment, you can copy it. So this is for Dynamics 365 environment. If you want sometimes, so you can create an environment with the database, that means the common data service. So without common data service also you can create environments for only the Power Apps, only for the Power Apps. So in my next video, I'm going to explain what type of environments you can provision, how we can create that environments, and what we will get, what we will not get it there in detail. Thank you so much for watching this video.